Hello, my name is Benedict. I am from KIT, Network Department. And yes, I tell you a short story of a strict uRPF implementation, which kindly is broken. First, we do a hardware replacement at the moment. I'm not allowed to talk about a vendor, and so I have to use some alternative names. And if I'm talk about the CAT, it's the old hardware, and always if the CAT is somewhere on the slide, that's the old hardware, and we are migrating to the new hardware, the Nexus. And if you see the shiny Nexus from StarCraft, it's the new hardware. Yeah. One of our goals in our network is to prevent address spoofing. All people should do it. Everyone who's participating in the internet to our customer ports. We usually use strict uRPF filtering like described in RFC 3704. It's very simple. The source address is used to look up in the FIB, and if the packet would go with the source address as destination out of the same port as the packet came in, the packet would be allowed, and if the packet wouldn't go out of the port, then it's blocked. We participate at manners. Everyone should do it. If you never heard about it, please Google it. Yeah, so simple explanation with our old hardware. You see the configuration on the right upper side. We've configured prefix, and in the fourth line, you see the configuration for strict uRPF. On the left downside, a server sends a packet with an address inside a configured prefix, and it's allowed by the old CAT because it's inside of the prefix. On the right side, someone tries to spoof and use a prefix outside of the configured prefix and gets blocked. It's totally easy. We like it. We don't have to use ACLs. So we use it. And it doesn't need any more TCAM because it's based on the FIB. Yeah. So we tested the new Nexus on the lab. And yeah, we tested it with Debian 9. Everything works. We tested with Windows 7 and Windows 10. Everything works. And then I used my laptop, and I used Gentoo, and my IPv6 packets got dropped. We didn't know what's happened at that time. Maybe I'm a Gentoo user. Maybe I've broken my system, so can be happened. Then later at the end of the test, one of my colleagues came and said, oh, my Arch is broken too. And that was weird. Two boxes which have issues. But Arch is also bleeding edge, maybe something there's broken too. We bought the product, brought it in production, and we found a workaround. We enabled this with sysctl. With this option, the Linux box sends an unsolicited neighbor advertisement every time an interface goes up. So it goes through the interfaces and sends packets to the router. So, oh, I'm here, I have this address, and the router fills the neighbor cache. We didn't understand why this helps, but it helps. We had a workaround. Nice. And the next day, Debian 10 was released, was also broken. The workaround works too. But at that point, we thought, oh, there must something strange go on, because Debian is really conservative in configuration change, and yeah, that's really awkward. And then a macOS user came, and macOS doesn't work either, and we didn't find a workaround. So we go back and use ACLs. We didn't like it, but it works for the moment. So we have to go back in the lab. We have to understand what's wrong. And we did look into the manual and find a sentence which says, oh, the neighbor must be known and the neighbor cache must be filled. And then strict uRPF works. We didn't understand it, but it looks like that's the right thing. As soon as the neighbor cache is filled, it works. And yeah, we don't know what strange thing does the vendor do. And so we opened the ticket in May, talked to the TAC. After 4 months, the TAC understands the issue. And he said, oh, it's documented, so we don't have to change something. And yeah, so he's right, it's documented. We saw it also, and then we asked them to be more clearly in the documentation that this implementation doesn't work with modern Linux kernel and macOS. The vendor decided to not change the documentation. They plan to change the implementation. They want to release at the end of November a fixed release, but we haven't heard yet from them. We didn't get a lab version to test, so we don't know if they fix it right or not. So I'm looking forward to what's happened. But there's another thing. What's about IPv4? They wrote ARP in the documentation, and we haven't seen any IPv4 issues yet. But shortly after, the load balancer guys came and said, hey, our load balancer setup is broken with the new network, and oh, that's strange. So I have to say one thing. With the new Nexus, we changed to EVPN VXLAN. We use Anycast gateways. On all these Nexus boxes, the gateway is configured. So for every host, the next switch is the gateway. So if a packet came from a client, it goes to the load balancer on the left side. The load balancer rewrites the source and destination MAX, and it goes through the same SVI, through the same VLAN, through the same broadcast domain to the other server. And the server answers the request, and it gets blocked on the Nexus. So what's happened here? We did look deeper into it, and yeah, the left switch learns the ARP and fills the ARP cache. And on the right side, the ARP cache isn't filled because it has to be on the left side. The F5 sends the ARP requests, and that's why it gets blocked. And so we found another situation where the implementation breaks IPv4. So now we have to use ACLs for IPv4 too. Yeah. Our conclusion, Gentoo and Arch Linux are not always broken. They are just up to date. You never find all limitations in the lab. And yeah. Talk to the vendor. They do sometimes strange implementation. Talk to them. They should change their implementation if there's something broken. We hope we can get them to change it. Yeah. And if you see something similar, please contact me. Send me a mail. It would be nice to hear if you have similar situations. Thank you.